Good morning, students. As I had promised you that we will going through the some numerical problems, and we will try to solve those problems and will revise our chapter thoroughly. So here we are with some questions related to your chapter electricity. We will solve these problems, these questions. I have here total 10 questions here. We will complete this worksheet basically and revise our chapter. Remember, the best way to practice the physics is to practice more and more physical problems, and that's why we are conducting this numerical session. So now I think that in your screen you can see that a first question is: a piece of wire of resistance R is cut into 5 equal parts. These parts are then connected in parallel. If the equivalent resistance of this combination is capital R dash, then the ratio of R upon R dash is. So basically this is a question ki suppose ye aapke paas ek wire hai and you divide this wire in 5 equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4. Suppose these are 5 equal parts, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So if the total resistance of this wire is capital R, and we know that resistance is directly proportional to L. So we have now 5 equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So each wire, each this small part will have the resistance R by 5. And it is clear that this part are connected in parallel. These wires are connected in parallel. So if for parallel, we know the formula is 1 upon R dash. You remember that we had done this type of derivation in previous lectures. We had taken the three resistances, and you know, one is R1, another is R2, another is R3. So the net resistance in parallel is 1 upon R equals to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. So by using the same law, we can calculate the net formula, net value of R dash, that is 5 by R plus 5 by R plus 5 by R plus 5 by R plus 5 upon R. Okay. So we have to calculate the net parallel resistances, that R1 upon R dash equals to, so 25 by R. In that case, value of R dash is R by 25. Okay. And now what is asked to you? The value of R over R dash, which means we can do the cross multiply here. We do the cross multiply here. Okay. So that is, we get R upon R dash equal to 25. So D is the right option. So this is how we can solve this type of problems. Remember, it is not possible that every time there is a numerical value is given to you in some physical problems. You have to solve this analytically also. And this question number one is the example of the same type of question. So I hope that you are getting my point, that how we can access the answer of this question. Now we are moving to the second part, second question. In second question, we have, which of the following term does not represent the electrical power in the circuit? It is asked that which is not representing the electric power. So as we had told you that power is rate of doing work, and work means potential into charge. Work means potential into charge by time. So Q by T becomes power, becomes current. So one is VI. So VI is here. It's good. It means ye iska function ho sakta hai. Now, if we know that V equals to IR from Ohm's law, so that's why it can transform into, if we put the value of V over here, it can be I square R. It means this is also the right. This is also the right. Now, if we use the value of I, that is V upon R, so we can get V square by R. So these are the three functions of power, three different formulation of power. So here I square R we have V square by R. Only thing which is not here is this I R square. Sorry. Yes, I square R yahan A. Okay. So here we can understand that VI means option C is here. I square R ye option A hai, B nahi hai. And V square by R, that is D. So the single option which is not representing the electrical power, that is option B, IR. So here IR square is the right answer. Right answer means in these four options, IR square is not representing the electric power. In that sense, this is the right answer. Okay. So now moving to the third question. In an electric bulb rated 220 volt and 100 watt. So 220 volt, it means it is putting given to your potential. And power is given to you 100 watt. The power consumed will be when it is open on 110 volt. When it is open in 110 volt, the power consumed will be. So first you should calculate that at this point, how much current it will draw. Okay, so as we know that P equals to VI. So I equals to P by V, that is 100 by 220. So that is I equals to 10 upon 22 ampere. Let remain this in fractional form because we know that it will be cancelled out in the next part. So now it is asked that when we use the 110 volt, then the power. So power at 110 volt, volt did 110, and current is 10 upon 22. So 11 tenja and 11 2ja 22, 2 5ja 10. So it is P equal to 10 into 5, that is 50 watt. So 50 watt means option C is the right answer. So in question A, this 25 is the right answer, IR square, and here is 50. You can take the screenshot in the mid of the video so that you can note down these questions on your copy and you can practice on your own. Okay. So I hope that you are getting this question that how we can solve this type of problems. Now we are moving to the next part, next questions, next set of questions. Here we have another question, question number 4. Two conducting wires of same material and equal length and equal diameter are first connected in series and then in parallel in an electric circuit. The ratio of the heat produced in series and parallel combination would be. Okay, so basically it is asked to calculate the heat. So that is, you should understand that heat energy is actually the kind of work. Energy is kind of work, heat is a kind of energy, and energy means work. So when we talk about, suppose we talk about the power. So power equals to V into I, and we can replace this current with the formula I equals to V by R. So we can write here power equals to V square upon R. Now, when we multiply, Joule's law of heating is said that heat energy H is somehow the, you know, V I square RT is a formula in terms of current, and in terms of resistance it is potential V square RT. So if the time is same, then suppose we can neglect in case of series. First it is connected in series and then connected in parallel. So basically the thing in which the heat is depend, that is resistance. Resistance is the deciding quantity on which the amount of heat generation is depend. So first we should calculate the resistance in series combination and resistance in parallel combination. So suppose here are we have a two resistances of same materials and same wire, same length, same diameter. First they connected in series and then they connected in parallel. So how we can calculate the resistance? Suppose this is R, this is R. So net resistance is 2R. And here the if this is R, this is R. So net resistance is 1 by R plus 1 by R. That is 2 by R. So on reciprocating we get R by 2. R by 2. So in case of 2R, in case of R by 2, the value of heat energy will be, the value of heat energy will be, for in case of H1, we have V square times 2R into time T. And in case of second, that is parallel, we have V square by R by 2 times T. Now, we have to take the, we have to find the ratio, so we can divide these two equations. Time and time is cancelled, V square and V square. R, so it become H1 upon H2 equals to 1 by 2R upon 2 by R. So it means 1 by 2R into R by 2, that is R and R cancelled. So H1 upon H2 equals to 1 ratio 4. So option C is the right answer. So this is the method of solving this type of problems. You can understand that it may look like that it is an optional question, so it may be a very short answer. You see, it is happening in the examination most of the time in boards also, that although it is an objective type question, it is a multiple choice question, but you have to solve those questions for getting the correct answer. So you have to increase your numerical ability, you have to develop your numerical ability so that you can solve these type of problems, students. Okay, so now we are closing to our next question, question number five, that is electric charge is expressed in, it is very easy question. Electric charge is expressed in means basically it is asking the unit of electric charge. What is the unit of electric charge? So we know that unit of electric charge is coulomb, and if it is asked to the CGS value, then it is stat coulomb. So remember this thing, that coulombs and stat coulombs can be the units of electric charge. Now in other terms, if it is being asked that, as we know that current I equals to Q by T, and it is written as one of the unit of charge is ampere second, then suppose if it is here written as ampere second and it is asked that electric charges can be expressed in, and there is one or more option E is available here, that C and D both. So we will choose option E. So remember that whenever this type of question which is related to particular unit or dimensions, then you have to very very clear, you have to very very conscious to reading that language of the question, what they are trying to ask. Okay, and then by going through the numericals, by going through the formula, you can decide that what units can be possible for that particular quantity, and then you can choose your answer. I hope that you are understanding this fact. Now, question number six is 10 to the power 10 electrons are removed from a natural body, neutral body. The charge acquired by the body is, so as you know that if suppose this is a body and 10 to the power 10 electrons are removed, 10 to the power 10 electrons are removed. So if the electrons are removed, then automatically first this body is getting positive charge. Iska matlab C option cannot be possible. पहले तो यही क्लियर हो गया. If the 10th power 10 electrons are removed, then automatically body will get positively charged. So C option cannot be possible. Now we are going to solve this. If 10th power 10 electrons, okay, and number electronic charge we have to calculate. Like charge is transferred 10th power 10, and the value of electronic charge is 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19. So as you know, 1.6 at 10 to power minus 19, it is plus 10. So 1.6 into 10 to power minus 9 positive. This much coulombic charge must that body have. So plus 1.6 into 10 to power minus 9, that is option number B is correct. So basically we are using here the formula of Q equals to NE, that is law of quantization of charge. Law of quantization of charge. Law of quantization of charge. Okay, so this law we are using here. I hope you can understand these questions also. Now we are moving to the next four questions, that is question number 7, 8, and 9 and 10. Okay. Question number 7 saying that when the distance between two charged particles is halved, the force between them becomes. When the distance between two charged particles is halved, the force between them becomes. So remember, I had told you that when there is a two charges, either they are of same polarity or different polarity, the electrostatic force between them is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Square of the distance between them. So if the distance is halved, if the distance is half, then first distance is decreasing, it means force increase ho jayega. If the distance is decreasing, it means force is increasing because it is inversely manner correlated with each other. So but the problem is that here is a square function over here. So if we take here to solving, that we can take a constant, suppose k over here, then it is 1 by r k by r square. So in case of first, that if k by r square, and in that second force F2, now the next is the distance is halved, which means r by 2 is square, which means r square by 4, and 4 will come to here, then k is cancelled, r square is cancelled, which means F1 over F2 equals to 1 ratio 4, which means the new force, the force between them becomes, which means new force F2 become the 4 times of F1, yani purane force se 4 guna force ho jayega, 4 times for the previous one. So that is option D is correct. Okay, so this type of questions can be asked also in the examination. Now the question number 8, the minimum value of charge on an object cannot be less than ki kisi bhi charge body par kitna minimum charge isse kam nahi ho sakta. Basically it is asking the lowest value. So as we know that from the quantization of charge, Q equals to NE, where Q is the charge, E is the electronic charge value, and N is the number of electrons. So the minimum value of N can be 1. Either 1 electron will transferred or 1 electron can be gained. So that's why the minimum value of charge can be plus or minus 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19 coulomb. इससे छोटी value नहीं हो सकती. So that is 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19 coulomb. Option number A is the right answer. Now the question number 9. Which of the following charge is not possible? There are 4 different charges given to you in the question. That is 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19 coulomb. This one, 3.2 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb, 6.4 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb, and 0.8 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. Now, from the quantization of law, we can see that charges can be transferred in terms of electron, that is the complete integer value of N, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. So here we can say, if we observe the option A, it is 1.6, which means, which is the correct one, lowest value, so ye possible ho sakta hai, bilkul sahi. 3.2, it is 2 times of 1.6, it means 2 times of electronic charge, yes, it is possible. Here you can see 6.4, okay, 6.4, 4. So this can also be possible. Okay, this can also be possible. The only thing which cannot be possible, 0.8. Why? Because it is the 1.6, it is equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 by 2. And as we know that fractional values cannot be possible, electron cannot be divided. So that's why option D is not possible. So in question number 9, the correct option is option number D, because 0.8 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb is impossible value of electronic charge which cannot be transferred. Now, the last question is question number 10. A flow of 10 to power 7 electrons, a flow of 10 to power 7 electrons, which means N equal to 10 to power 7 electrons per second in a conductor constitutes a current. Okay, so current ki value humse puchhi gayi hai, that is I equals to Q by T, Q ki value N times E, ab ye quantization of loss hai, and time T. Okay, so N ki value humein di hai 10 to power 7, electronic charge ki value 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19. Just a minute. Okay, 1.6 into 10 power minus 19. Okay, let me solve here. So it is asked that current, value of current is Q by T, value of Q is NE by T, the value of N is given to you 10 to power 7, value of electronic charge is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19, time is 1 second. So current I equals to, that is 1.6 into 10 to power minus 12, minus 12 ampere. So here is option number C is correct answer. Option number C is correct answer. So in this small worksheet, I hope that you can understand the questions, how we can solve these. So in question number 1, the 25 is the right answer. Here is IR square R. Here is, we get the 50 volt, we remember it. And it is 1:4 here. Here is coulomb, and 10 power 10 electrons are removed from the body, then the total charge is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 caused. Okay, so these are the questions which we had solved today. So I recommend you to, you please can take the screenshot so that you can note down the questions and their answers, and you can solve them. Okay, so now you have a questions, you have their your answer key. I recommend you to please solve this question by your own at least one time, so that you can understand that how we will do the calculation in this chapter. In next lectures, in next session, we will do some more numerical sessions of different questions. Here we are going to solve the resistance combination problems, okay, which are very, very important in your curriculum. Okay, so stay tuned, stay with us. If you are first time, then please like, share and subscribe. Thank you so much, students.